A very common and old marketing strategy is to create and manage a level of artificial scarcity just enough to calibrate and maintain the desired purchasing level. For example, a company will be getting ready to release a new product and advertise like crazy, building up massive demand. Then they purposely release not nearly enough products to satisfy the demand that they've previously created. One law of economics that is extremely predictable is the law of unintended consequences. For example, during the financial panic of 2008, the Federal Reserve purposely lowered interest rates and significantly added to the money supply. Broadly speaking, this was supposed to prime the pump to encourage people to borrow money, start businesses, and hopefully jumpstart the economy. One of the theories that intends to explain why we are now living during the time of peak humanity is the finite soul theory, that there is and always has been a finite number of spiritual beings, and ever since Homo sapiens evolved enough brain power to house our thinking capacity, we've been slowly popping in as the population has been swelling. But just like a pendulum swinging back and forth, we've reached the point where the maximum number of souls can coexist in one physical plane. This, of course, means the population will start to decrease rapidly. There is a big problem in cosmology which has been kept secret until very recently. The problem is that there is not nearly enough helium to support the Big Bang theory of creation. Another theory, aside from the Big Bang theory, is that our universe was slowly, not quickly, brought into existence by some kind of meta-quantum process. That our universe was slowly split from another equal and opposite universe, very much like matter and antimatter. And since now we are at peak separation, the two universes are being slowly pulled back together, ultimately canceling each other out. As this is a slow process, some entities from this universe will slide into the other universe and vice versa. When entities from the other universe slide into ours, they will be perceived as demons or angels depending on their temperament. And as entities from this universe slide into theirs, they will be perceived similarly. But as this accelerates, there will be localized areas of space-time where the two universes coexist. Since we will be both drawn and repulsed by our opposite entities, this will represent a mutual desire for destruction, a doppelganger death dance apocalypse. Once the soul pendulum starts swinging back in the other direction, the collapse will come quickly. Building complex societies, emergent systems on top of emergent systems with greater and greater energy needs is a very slow process. But going in the other direction is very quick, very unexpected, and chaotic. Instead of small business owners or even potential homeowners borrowing money to jumpstart the economy, the new money was used by CEOs. They would borrow a ton of money at very low interest rates. They would use the borrowed money to buy back their own shares, significantly increasing their share price and their own compensation, which is heavily dependent on the share price. Now we have a situation where the stock and bond markets are overly inflated and large companies have tons of debt, which means if interest rates rise just a small amount, both the stock market and the bond markets will crash and most large companies will be unable to service their debt and be forced to lay off all employees. Needless to say, the Fed is trapped and they need to keep printing money. But if they keep printing money, eventually something will break. But if they stop printing money, everything will suddenly break. Even large universities use the artificial scarcity strategy. Harvard, for example, spends millions of dollars so they can get several hundred thousand applications every year. Since they know they can only take in a couple thousand students, this massive amount of artificial scarcity allows them to create extremely high tuition. Then this forces students to have to borrow money, which is part of the reason behind the student loan crisis. A combination of engineered and artificial scarcity and an economy that is flooded with artificial money. When this thing pops, it's going to be a doozy.